FedEx Field in Landover, Maryland. It's week three of the NFL on EA Sports.
So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. They go play action here on first down. They'll roll him out right. And this one is incomplete.
That was an interesting look there, because as soon as he got outside the pocket, I thought he was going to take off and run for yardage. But what often happens now with these quarterbacks who can move, defenses want to try and keep bodies in front of them. And I think that discouraged him from taking off and made him try a pass downfield that fell incomplete. Nice back-to-back plays defensively. They're stacking momentum now. One incompletion, two incompletion. They're going for more.
Out of the gun now on third down. And incomplete on the deep ball.
Brandon, we saw these defenders flying to the football in their win last week, and nothing has changed. They're still moving around quickly and forcing incompletions.
They're going to try and throw. He'll buy some time right. Now he's got this almost to the 40 before going out. A curious decision to go for it, but it pays off with a first down.
But there's one thing they are lacking in is confidence. They took a big and maybe unnecessary risk going for that fourth down. He put them on his shoulders, though, and paid off the big-time gamble.
There's a throw over the middle. It's taken in by his tight end. The numbers for Green in last week's ball game: 4 catches, 57 yards.
And they think they have a matchup advantage in this one. They're going to try and find some space for him to work and make sure he touches the football.
And he'll be stopped at the 46, gain of 3. It's been a 7-play opening drive, and this is third and short. And he's got the first down yardage there as he takes it just across midfield. From Commander's territory now, it's first and 10 at the 49-yard line. Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. A good pickup there, a 22. And on this first drive, looks like they want to get that vertical passing game going early.
And they did, and what a warning shot they just fired. If you're not going to back up and play coverage deep, we're going to attack you all game long. And once you adjust to that and you start to back off, then that opens things up underneath. A really nice start for them. Great way to get the game going.
They'll look to throw here on first down. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Chapman. And he'll be marked down right at the 20-yard line. On second down now, it's Graham. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. 7 yards there and a first down. He'll drop to throw. And it's caught. Touchdown. A great effort there. His first touchdown of the new season. And the Desperados are on the board first here this afternoon. This is a crew. They've come out flat their last two games, both losses. But just judging by the energy level, they look different here early in that time. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. They got the ball now following a big play, keeping the other guys out of the end zone. Now they'll start deep in their own territory, first and 10. And he's taken down, but able to get this up to the 20-yard line. Solid way to start the drive, 13 yards, picking up the first. So the previous play, a big help, as now they'll have it first and 10 up at the 20. Right back to him on first down. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. The defense was ready for the run pass option, diagnosed it perfectly.
Not only did they stack him up at the point of attack, but he was met by a host of light-colored jerseys.
Here we go on second and 12. Escaping the pressure right. Finding Green complete. I see an extra defensive back on the field. Little surprise here on third and one. And there's a leaping effort, but it's knocked away and incomplete.
Now that's a good bounce back after giving up a touchdown on the opening drive. Just one first down permitted and then out. Obviously, no loss of confidence with that defense, and now they get to turn it back to their offense.
They're indeed going for it as they look to throw. And he'll be taken down, but he does have first down yardage.
And we get a stoppage because, as you can see, a member of the Commanders in some obvious discomfort. The medical staff is going to come out here and take a look, and we will take a short break.
On first down, Graham. And he maneuvers up the middle for three, and it's second down. 3 yards on that last carry. Here's second and seven. He's going to rifle one deep left side. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
A lot of contact there, but there's no way it appeared that he was going to get a flag on that one. Looking for it, but he wasn't going to get it. And as an ex-defensive back, you love it when they let you play and jostle downfield.
And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 39. Back to throw now on first down. Got his man complete over the middle. It's Chapman. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Over the middle, complete. That's Chapman. And all the way down inside the 5 to the 4. Two big plays in succession. Not sure this D knows what hit him, but now they got to get ready. It's first and goal. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
That's a pretty play there. Got in at the last second, helped force the ball free, and kept them out of the end zone.
Line of scrimmage, again the 4-yard line. Second and goal. The middle they go. Graham. And he's maybe going to get this back to the 4, but that's about all. They'll look to throw on third and goal. Flushed out right. And it's caught. Touchdown. A great play there. His 6th touchdown of the season. And the Desperados go nearly the length of the field and finish it off with 6 points.
He was able to move around and found some vision to throw the football. And how about how he...
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive.
Early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game. But I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally, because all division games have a little extra to them. But I like where this game is situated, because at this stage of the season, it has that little extra juice, but at the same time, it's not a make or break if this were, let's say, week 15, 16, somewhere in that neighborhood.
So after the incompletion on first, now second and 10. He'll look to throw. Buying time to it, and he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down.
Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts.
So as they take it over, we step aside.
An extra man in the secondary for Washington on third down.
Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed. A real letdown defensively. That was third and a bundle, but they allow the conversion. Side and it's complete. And all the way inside the 15 before they drop him. Give him 30 yards there.
I think this defense was still trying to recover from that last play, so you wonder if they were ready for this one. You have to imagine their defensive coaches are yelling at them to get focused, because if they don't, more plays like that will result in giving up points.
So how about this for field position after the big play? Inside the 15 now as they come up on first and 10.
red zone now. They'll look to throw to the end zone, but it's incomplete.
The way he's been slinging in the first half, you expect everything he throws to go for a touchdown, but I guess he's going to have to wait to try and pick up that third, isn't it?
Yeah, I thought he had him for a second, but you're right, not to be. The play action fake. They'll look to throw, and he's going to go down. He sacked back at the 24. That winds up pushing him back 11 yards on the sack. And that'll bring up third. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw, eluding the pressure right. And he'll just toss it away. So he throws it away, and that brings up fourth down. The Commanders' defense holds, and that'll bring up fourth down. Back to throw. And he is trying to get to the marker. Gonna depend on the spot, but I'm not sure he got there, and he did not. So they've converted their first two fourth down attempts. Not there. Now they're 2 for 3.
You think maybe the offense coordinator expended a little capital?
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. But Charles, they still have the lead despite their defense giving up a touchdown on the previous possession. And even though they have that lead, it feels like a back-and-forth ball game where to try to get momentum back, maybe they need at least 3 here on this drive.
I think you're right about that, Brandon, because your game plan doesn't change. I do believe your urgency does because of the last score that went against your team. So what you want to do now is have your own drive and try and make sure that that momentum stays in your camp.
They're going to look to throw. Throwing left side, it's complete. And way up past the 35 before he's taken down. A throw over the middle, taken in. And they bring him to the ground just shy of midfield. And now they're in the hurry up. They'll look to throw now on first down. High throw, but he makes the catch. And he'll be dropped just shy of the 35 at the 34. A pickup of 17 on a play that originated at the 17. In Washington territory now. Here's first and 10 at the 34. Flush to his right. And time finally runs out. He can't get rid of the football, and he's taken down. Second and long. He finds his man complete. It's Chapman. And they move this all the way down to the 9. That one goes for 30 yards. I guess that answers the question of whether or not they're going to try to play conservative and protect this lead in the third quarter.
And I think this is something we're seeing more and more of in the NFL. Teams not playing to protect leads. Teams playing to extend them.
The chain gang hustling to catch up. Here's first and goal from just inside the 10. Now a handoff up the middle. It's Graham. Only about a yard there as he takes it from the 9 to the 8. On second down, it's Graham. And he'll work his way closer to the goal line as he's got 5 down to the 3. On third down, Graham. And he's not even going to get back to the line of scrimmage. Washington is able to come up with a goal line stand. The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. He's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. 44 yards rushing for him now as he's run it 11 times. Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. They'll keep it on the ground. Graham. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32. The run only got a yard. Here's second and 9.
Up the middle they go. It's Graham. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5. And the offense moving quickly to the line. Now back to throw. Rush coming, and he's taken down. They'll drop to throw. And it's incomplete. They cannot convert, and they turn it over. A fourth down pass play doesn't work out. The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive. Another important fourth quarter series coming up. That last INT helping to maintain their slim advantage. Now a throw right side taken in here to start this drive. And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Now this one over the middle into the hands of his tight end, complete. An ideal spot here to get a first down and try to run some more clock. And this is 2nd and less than a yard. Escaping the pressure right. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. Here we go, 3rd and 1. Gut check time on both sides. And the slant complete to Green. And he'll be taken down here just shy of the 30. Now on 1st down, he'll drop to throw it. Flushed out right. And he'll be marked down at about the 26-yard line. He'll get 5 out of the scramble. It's 2nd down. 4th quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a 1-score game. So it's our visitors with a football as we get you reset. They've got a 2nd down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. 2nd down now. It's Graham. And not much of a hole there as he gets it down to about the 24-yard line. And now right out of the 2-minute break, we'll get a timeout used defensively with 1:56 to go. This is a big 3rd down, and you'd have to think we'd see a timeout right away if they can't stop him here. Now a handoff up the middle. Arrington. And he is going to have the 1st down, and that is going to suck the life right out of this crowd. Now Washington going to use the 2nd of their 3 timeouts. That'll leave them with just 1 remaining in this 4th quarter of play. Not totally home free yet, but it's looking good as they come up 1st and 10. He'll get 8 on the scramble there. It'll be 2nd and a couple. Up the middle they go. Graham, and he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Now the defense will burn their 3rd and final timeout as they'll head to the sideline and talk over what to do next. On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. What a huge touchdown that was, obviously. Here. Materializing there on the 1st down run. He'll get a couple and that's it. This, in all probability, another run here on 2nd and 8. They'll keep it on the ground. Graham, and he
carries this one past the midfield stripe and into Commander territory.
Charles, why didn't they just take the knee there?
You're asking the question that I'm asking as well, because we've seen a lot of football where coaches decide maybe they get a little greedy. I don't know if they're doing it for stats or for what reason. We've seen it happen in college. And how about the NFL? The miracle of the Meadowlands. All they had to do was take a knee and the game was over. The Giants ran it one more time. Ball popped free. Philadelphia picks it up and wins the game.
What year was that?
1978. I think it was in November.
So this crowd will not go home happy. It's a victory for our visitors. And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle, go on to victory. Now the guys believe. You move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.